Friends and followers, I'm posting this video after a gap of 1 month. I was kind of held up in some other stuff. My apologies. But if you remember, I'm guessing 4 months back, I made a video on how you can make handmade soap. And this is what happened. Yeah, I know. I made the terrible mistake of adding water to sodium hydroxide. It didn't splatter on me last time, but you should not do that. It's very similar to why you should always, if you're diluting some concentrated acid, let's say sulfuric acid, then you never add the water to the sulfuric acid. You always have the acid slowly added to the water. So in this case also it's something similar, because there's a lot of heat evolved during the dissolution of sodium hydroxide in water, and all sorts of bad things can happen. There's a theory out there as to why you should never add water to the lye. Anyway, having said that, this time I'm not going to make a solid bar of soap. I'm targeting a liquid soap. So to make liquid soap, you need, or to make any soap, you need a strong base. The common base is sodium hydroxide, which gives you your standard bar of soap. But for a liquid soap, you're better off using potassium hydroxide. So that is what I'm going to be using. I'm going to measure that out and then add it slowly to water. Last time also, a couple of my commenters and viewers on YouTube pointed out that I should be using a soap calculator. Me personally, I like doing the math myself. Last time the math kind of checked out, it was a perfectly usable bar of soap, but this time I am going to use a soap calculator, so I don't have the phone here with me, but anyway, it's probably right there. And I'm going to use a mixture of clarified butter, ghee as it is called in this part of the world, and the rest of it would be your sunflower oil. I am also going to add some fragrance to this. I never used fragrance in my soap when I was making my Aleppo soap or Nabu soap, because they don't have any smell. But this time I am going to add some smell. So this is lemon essential oil. How much is this? It's about 15 milliliters, so that's good enough. So let's get started.
So actually soap, as we know, it is made by reacting a mixture of different oils with a strong base like sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide. It is a potassium hydroxide here that I'm measuring out, and I'm targeting here about 184 grams. That's the measurement that I got from the soap calculator. And if you notice, I'm using my rubber gloves, plus I'm wearing eye protection, because this is some nasty stuff. Yeah, so that's 100 grams, and I have to measure out another 84 grams of this stuff. Okay, so that's about 300 grams or 300 milliliters of water, and that's the amount of water that I'll need to dissolve all the potassium hydroxide that I just measured out. And this is supposed to be the correct way of doing this, and you don't want to add a whole lot together, because this thing will heat up like real crazy. So I guess the idea here is to add a little at a time. And what I'm going to do is just let this thing dissolve as much as possible and let it cool down. And then I'm going to add the remaining 100 grams of this stuff. Oh yeah, even through my gloves, I can feel it. It's really hot. Okay, so now that the lye solution is ready, I have measured out in this pot 100 grams of sunflower oil and 100 grams of clarified butter. Again, that's called ghee in India. So now that the lye solution is sort of cool to the touch, it's not quite cool down to room temperature, but that's okay. I'm guessing it's about 45-50 degrees. That should be fine. And now I'm going to add the lye solution to the fats and oils which I measured out. I am also going to lay down some tissue paper just in case I have some drips. Good. So again, when you handle lye, please wear eye protection as well as really thick gloves. Those drops. Awesome. And now make sure you keep this out of the way because this still has some residual lye on the inside. You don't want to touch that, so please take that away. So now what you want to do is keep on mixing this thing till the mixture thickens up. That's called the trace. And that's when you know that the reaction is progressing quite well. And basically what you're trying to do is form an emulsion of the sodium, of the potassium hydroxide and the fats that you have used. You can already see the mixture is turning opaque, and that means that it's getting emulsified. By the way, you can use one of those stick blenders, and that gets the job, that makes the job a lot easier. You can do it with the standard wick, it's just that you have to keep stirring for a long time. Okay guys, so after a lot of mixing, I think my mixture of oil and potassium hydroxide has reached what I would like to call as a light trace. That's okay, I don't want a heavy trace because I'm targeting a liquid soap. And now that we are towards the end of the reaction, what I'm going to add is about 15 milliliters of the lemon essential oil into the mix. Oh yeah. So okay. The reaction, although it's almost complete, is still not quite done. You have to let this rest for about 14 days so that all the lye can react with the oils. You don't want any free lye to be in the soap you want to use. So after 14 days, this will be ready for use, and I'll give you a review of what it's like after 14 days. Cool.
So guys, it's been about 20 days. This is what the final product turned out to be like. It's a perfectly usable hand soap. I've been using it for a couple of days now. A lot less harsh than I think some of the products available commercially. The color I honestly didn't like. It didn't turn out to be white. It's sort of a rather dirty yellow. So next time I might add some dyes to it to make it a little more pleasing. But yeah, I certainly look forward to using this around the house. And oh, by the way guys, life has been really crazy in the last 1 month. I have not been able to devote as much time I would have liked to VK Organic, so again my apologies there. But nevertheless, I hope that you have liked this small video on soap making and going over some of the things that I did wrong last time. So having said that, you guys have a nice day and I'll see you next time. Goodbye.